A TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. APH Braille Print Protractor, Part 12. Labeling tactile angles drawn on the APH Draftsman. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
And so I've got this great thing now. We can put the name on two different ways. When I have students, I will say, well, we're going to need to put our name on this. And what I usually like them to do because of this wonderful surface is, remember, they are supposed to know how to do their signature. So what I tell them to do is I want them to sign this. And we oftentimes look for every chance we can get for them to practice that signature. And this is an excellent time. So I could try to put this in the Braille writer, but for right now, I'm going to ask them to just go ahead and sign their work. So whatever their technique might be, they might get a signature guide out. I'm not going to use that for right now, but they might go ahead and there they put their name. And it's amazing. They love it. They can actually feel. Maybe some of them have just printed it. And they can go back and feel their name in print. They get so excited just putting their name, practicing writing their name. Think about that. It's math class, but you can still have signature writing as part of math class. Now, most of them will not be able to probably write in their particular angle degree. This is where this gets a little more difficult than the plain Braille paper, but I'm going to do it just to prove that it's possible. And that is, you can take this out. We have done this, but I hope it'll work today on the camera. Okay, we're going to go get our Braille writer. And I'm going to tell you, we have to be very careful. and I did do this, so I hope it works. And I don't think I'm going to set it just so I can get this right. That's another little kind of a technique of mine. Sometimes I don't actually set the paper so I can move this around a little bit more like that. In other words, it's not just going line by line, so I can get right where I need. Okay, now I have to put 110 in there. So I think, now if the student wants to be exact, they can sit there and go, okay, let me say da-da-da-da. Number time 110. But guys, these are not transcribers. We don't need them to make it as perfect as a transcriber. But okay, 110. Then they can just move over. Now I think I'm just going to move it over if I can. Okay, I might go up just slightly. And this one is the 70. And then I'm going to come over here. I might have to go back down because I think this is a little bit. And again, they can be figuring this out, checking where everything is, and go, maybe I'll go up just a little bit. And this was my 90. This is all number code, remember? I think my bell just rang, and I have to move my margin to get that zero in there. And I'm going to take this out so that you can really see it a little better. But, And I'm going to tell you, this is not the easiest thing because you have to be very, very careful when you're putting that in the Braille writer. But let me see. Do I have some of that yellow paper? I don't know if that would make it look better or worse, the contrast. Let's see. Aha! Now, I think you can see the pen. Let's see if can the camera pick up on the 110 and the 70 and the 90, though. I don't know. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so I think this is very professional looking. I mean, your students could actually make some really professional looking drawings, and then to have their signature or their, print name at the bottom, it just looks fantastic. Okay, so if you can't tell, this is kind of my favorite method now. I really like the Draftsman, and I want to be sure that you all are aware of what it can do. So, again, we have this that we can hand into the math teacher. They know it's Susan's work. In case they cannot read these numbers in Nemeth code, now let's see. All right. I know it's here. There's my ballpoint pen. VI teacher can come along if they want to and go ahead. I need to be on a little harder surface though. No, I know. I'll just get the Draftsman back. So take this off. So the math, VI teacher may want to come along and put 110 degrees, 70 degrees, and 90 degrees. And let's see, I'll put that back under the yellow paper just to see if you can see that a little better. And so now that's ready to go right into the math teacher who can't read the 110, the 70, and the 90. And anyway, I'm just trying to show you the complete package of drawing these particular angles. And if you don't think this isn't fun, I mean, I hope you're having fun watching, but I'm having fun doing it, and the students really think it's fun too. So please let them draw angles. A lot of people unfortunately think, oh, this is such a terrible thing to make those poor little blind children do. Those poor little blind children love doing it. They consider this, and I consider it artistic. Wow. And this is the only way I can be artistic, so I'm all excited about this. So again, make sure that you let your students draw angles, because it's not only beautiful, it's also fun. So please let them have some fun.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Braille Print Protractor. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on math for the blind and visually impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Program. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009, all rights reserved.